Hello friends, have you ever wondered why tree trunks are in cylindrical shapes? Or the kitchen utensils in larger volume are in round shapes? Let's find it out with an interesting activity using these three postcards with the similar dimensions. Or if you don't have postcards, you can use the card sheet cutouts with the same dimensions. And these postcards were back in days used for delivering the messages, and today we will use them to find out what the answer of this interesting activity. Can you tell me what is the shape of this postcard? So yes, it is a perfectly rectangle with the length of 14.5 cm and breadth is 9.5 cm. So as we all know, the formula for the surface area of rectangle is length into breadth. So here it will be 14.5 cm length, 9.5 cm breadth. So total surface area will be 137.75 cm². And all these three postcards are of similar length, similar breadth, and hence similar surface area. Now we will fold these three postcards widthwise to form different shapes. First, we will see about a circular base shape which is known as cylinder. So we will form it like this. So this is the cylinder shape, and we will tape it over here with the help of this blue tape. So as we made circular base cylinder, we have made three different shapes like this. So this is a regular circular base cylinder which is known as cylinder. Let's mark it as A. This is the square base cylinder which will be marked as a B, and it is known as the cuboid. And this is the triangle base cylinder which we will mark as a C, and which is known as prism. But make sure while making these shapes, the edges will just touch each other and do not overlap, and then only apply a tape. We have made these three shapes of the cylinders with a similar postcards. Even though shapes are different, we can see that their height is same. But how can we know that which cylinder have the greatest volume? Can we find out without the actual mathematical formula? So let's try it out with filling some material into each of this cylinder. We have these three shapes and these pulses. So we will found which shape will hold maximum volume. Let's for that keep these shapes in the plate standstill and fill them with the pulses. So we have filled these three shapes completely with these pulses. Now let's take them out one by one to find out which holds the maximum amount. So this is regular cylinder with spherical base. This is square base cylinder, that is cuboid, and this is triangle base cylinder, that is prism. By observing these three plates, we can see that three of them have different volume of pulses. So prism contains lowest volume, followed by the cuboid and then cylinders. Hence we can say that cylinder have the largest volume among all of these three. So now let us calculate the actual volume of these three shapes using the mathematical formula, which is volume of any cylinder will be area of the base into height of this cylinders. So volume of this cylinder is pi r square h. So pi r square is area of this base and h is the height. So pi is 3.14, r will be calculated, so this is 4.6, and half of this is 2.3 and square of it, and then we'll multiply this with the 9.5 centimeter, which is the height of this cylinder. So total volume of this cylinder A will be 157.90 centimeter cube. So now we'll go with this square base cylinder, which is cuboid. So volume of this cuboid will be side length square and height. So side length is 3.62 centimeter and height is 9.5 centimeter, same as previous. So the total volume of this cuboid will be 124.49 centimeter cube. And now this triangle base prism, so volume of this cylinder C, that is prism, will be half base into height, and this half base into height is nothing but the area of this triangle. And to find volume of this total cylinder, we will multiply this with the help of height, that is 9.5 centimeter. So base is 4.8 and height is 4.2. So total volume of this prism will be 95.76 centimeter cube. So from all these volumes, we have found out that 157.90 centimeter cube is the highest volume which is of this cylinder. As we have seen, this circular base cylinder holds maximum content of postcards. Also, we have found it from the mathematical formula that it holds the maximum volume. So, natural objects like trees tend to grow in the cylindrical shape to acquire maximum volume in minimum surface area. Same is the case for the kitchen utensils. So, this was today's our hands-on maths activity. I hope you have learned something new and had fun also. So for more such videos, please do watch our YouTube channel, IISER Pune Science Activity Center. Have fun. Thank you.